Hello everybody, this is Andrew for GameZone, and we are back in Modula after finishing the Earthen Peak. We actually didn't die at all in that episode, so that's good. Do we have any of these? Nope. Probably got enough to level up or so. What were we doing? Got a lot of endurance. Ooh, our adaptability is low! What are we doing? That's unacceptable. That's gonna have us run into some issues. So let's fix that. We're close enough to leveling, so let's use one of these guys. That's just 1,000. Probably need... I know I can use more than one at a time. I was just doing it as I was gauging it. I think that should be enough. Yep. Wow, our stats are kind of low. It's that int I'm not used to, I guess. So let's see if we can get that Covetous Silver Serpent Ring from this lady.
You would be coldish not to... If you want
to... Alright, so we need to buy some stuff. You gotta spend money to make money. I always use more of those. So, by actually getting the Covetous Silver Serpent Ring plus one, we'll be making a lot of money, so let's get some souls to get that. Is 5,000 enough for you? Let's buy 2 more of these. 3 more of these. Even better. Boom! So that's a huge upgrade. You can really do that anytime. I don't know why I haven't done that, but you can't wear both rings at the same time, or I would wear all of those, because I love my Covetous Silver Serpent Ring. Alright, so we're at Upper Earthen Peak here. We were on our way to the Iron Keep when we decided that I forgot to show you that bonfire. So I ran back and bonfired it up. So now we're going to leave from the bonfire right before the boss room, and the boss is already dead, and then head up to the Iron Keep. How are you supposed to find that? Whoops, that is just a lot of wrong. We have a lot of room to burn Estus flasks because we are going to be hitting a bonfire in like 2 seconds. So we have room to be bad. Apparently what I did worked because these guys are kind of whoa, you're not dead. Can be a little tough sometimes. That one guy like went after me and the other's just, I don't know, I'm doing weird stuff. Alright, well, I was going to try to parry that guy, but apparently I died. Oh, boy. Well, I don't want to be alive anyways. Being alive is too much pressure. So all of last episode, we didn't die. And then the beginning of this episode, within the first 3 minutes, I decided to practice parrying and get killed. So, yeah. Can't say I didn't deserve that, I guess. It is possible to plunging attack these guys. See, what happened is that Dark Souls gave me a bone, and I was like, nah, this is Dark Souls. Alright, let's grab this before I die. I could just run past there and continue on with my life, but I see there was an item I missed back there. Use that to make a poison weapon, which we will definitely not be doing. That was a terrible jump, and I rolled in the poison, which you see the poison is actually climbing, even though I got out of it. It's because my clothes are covered in it. It won't be enough to poison me, but it's obnoxious none the same. Alright, well, Rei's wearing her SARS mask now, because she does not want to deal with the poison. Times, man. Oh, well, that explains a lot. For some reason, I was trying to parry with block. Sometimes you just make dumb mistakes, so that explains a lot. Whoops. Slow elevator is slow. Okay, so this is Iron Keep time. I love this area. It just looks so cool. So just like, I mean, it's called Iron Keep, so when I say it looks metallic, I feel like I'm just saying the obvious, but it looks metallic. We're about to meet a really good merchant, and he can actually get you into the Dragon Covenant if that's what you are so interested in, but not right now. If you're slow enough, you can actually pull one of these guys. Yeah, there you go. These guys can be really fast and thrust very far. They use like these blackened katanas, which I think have a dex of B, which is really good, actually. So he did. They kind of like have this like anime run, like that, really fast. I like to roll back and then just walk up and punish them, like that. There's nothing on either of these sides. There's these gates that lead to lava. Just showing you that I'm not crazy. Excuse me. Nothing immediately awful in this door. There's two guys here. If you're slow enough, you can pull this guy by himself. Yeah. Sometimes if you just attack them, you get the hit before they do. But otherwise, you go punch for punch. Since we're already dead, we're going to grab this item. I just slowly walk towards it and keep pressing the action button A on Xbox, and I can usually get it with only taking a little damage, like so. That is the key that will open the door in Cardinal Tower in the very beginning of the game near the Last Giant. So here's another dude. Incense will... Oh, I guess they're spells. Oh, they reduce the int cost for certain spells you own. Somewhat important to magic casters. Gonna buy that. We can always use those. This is another guy we want to spend a lot of money in. These are the great stones. The hello, thank you from Dark Souls of the giant that carves them. What was this? Hawkeye Goth? Yeah, there we go. The Jester suit is really awesome. If you're playing online or PvPing, you're going to see a lot of people wearing this thing. The hat increases magic find. The armor removes crit chances, so you don't get crit against, I think, riposte or backstabs. The gloves we're going to buy because they increase soul intake, and the thigh tights decrease fall damage. So that whole set does amazing things. And it upgrades the normal Titanite path. We are actually going to put on the Jester gloves. Because they don't look terrible. Can barely even tell any difference. And they are going to increase our soul intake. So, whoops. Or I'm just going to take them off. Effect increases number of souls acquired. So that's pretty wonderful. So combine that with our Covenant Silver Serpent Ring. Boom. Plus one now. This episode alone, we've upgraded our soul intake a lot. So this guy just dropped 924 souls. Not too shabby. Whoops! That's not what I wanted to do at all. Glad I already killed those guys, or that could have been messy. If we spend... Oh, always a good item. There is a secret here. Yeah. Hurrah for door. And then there is another secret here. Then you can shoot this dude with a ballista. But I don't like to go down that way because I think it's harder. So we're going to continue going this way. You can get this guy to see you. There's normally a guy there. Hey, buddy. Oh, I probably got freaked out by the... Oh, now we're going to have to deal with two or three of these guys. Three. Oh, I was hoping I could kill that one. Oh, boy. Well, they're like three stoogesing in the door. Okay. Well, that guy could have killed me, but decided he didn't want to. Oh, he's got a bow. All right, let's see if we can drop one. See if we can... Oh, they both have bows. Ooh, sometimes I do the wrong attack. Okay. I get it. You're mad. You're angry. I did some things you didn't appreciate. That's the Black Steel Katana. I think it has a B on Dex, which is pretty good. And it has wide slices, kind of like Aijutsu stuff, but I prefer the thrust. The quick thrust, too, not like that Uchi bullcrap. This dude is super annoying. If you have range, just kill him. He's going to shoot these ballisticized, like, Black Knight style lance arrows at you. Not a fan. Because of that guy, really, I like to draw all these... Ow. I like to draw all these guys out, because I don't want to take that guy's crap. Drag him under... Whoa! That guy is fast! Draw him under the awning where he can't hurt anybody. Drink up. We're going to do an item run before we fight the boss. The boss can be a huge pain in the butt and is pretty tough if you don't know the fight. I know the... Whoa. We can actually get hit by two archers here, so let's kill this guy as fast as possible. Let's pull this lever, which I'm sure... Oh, we just shot, so now's a great time to go. That pulls this thing down, so we can get on that platform now. But we are going to continue this way. Get these items, or item, items. Got to fall here, there's no choice. Roll, soften up the damage. Grab this item. Head back up the ladder. For these guys, I like to lock on them and only attack once at a time because you can push them off pretty easily, but you don't want to go with them. See, you didn't fall, push them again, boom. If I attacked them one more time, I probably would have walked off the edge. Not a mimic. Twinkling Titanite, Life Ring plus one. Don't care. Whee! Alright, so now we gotta deal with this bridge guy. Again, I find it... for that exact reason, find it safe. He doesn't want to come chase me because he wants to fight me where that guy can shoot me. But we're not gonna play his game. Sometimes this guy runs off the cliff too, which is funny. Case point. So we want to turn... Oh, okay, wow, that was close. Yikes. Want to turn... That turns off the fire in that room. That's why I didn't open that door before. It's just a room of fire. In the new world, the currency is fire. So now... Oh, boy. This will finish this bridge down so we can walk across it now. What a jerk. Good thing about these guys is they fire really slowly. The bad news is they do a lot of damage. Yikes. All right, so yeah, let's get in this room. Oh, I think I heard someone trying to stab me. Nope. Petrified dragon bones are good for upgrading boss weapons, I believe. There's an item here. These are the captains. They wear, like, the fur cloaks. They're cool. They do a lot of, like, flourishing sword stuff if I let him. I'd rather push him off the ledge and not fall off myself. He was worth 1,000-something souls, so captains are definitely worth killing. Lighting these, I'm not sure what they do, but it's a thing you can do. And they stay lit, so it makes me feel like they're doing something, but I don't know what it is. If you know what that does, feel free to leave a comment. So now I have to go around, so we have to go through here. This is where that one dude was, that his back was towards us in the beginning. That sniper guy is still up there, so... Yeah, there he is. This is the last guy... Whoa, that was a weird jump. Yeah, he's not even pointing in the right direction. Don't do nearly... Whoa, watch this. Oh, he didn't do it. It's the other attack. He, like, spins his freaking katana around. Looks awesome. That's the Smelter Demon. Oh, that guy's still sniping me. Don't want to fight him. What does this say? Quite something. Alright, let's put a message down. Let's say... visions of... Creatures, visions of giant. Therefore, creatures. Giant. Visions of giant, therefore giant. Because in here we have Zweihander. Yep. Yep, yep, yep. So here's how to get the dull ember. Jump! And it's right here. This is what you give to McDuff. And he will be able to infuse weapons. Cool thing about McDuff is he sells a bunch of Eastern weapons. I know some of you just... Oh, jeez, he almost knocked me off. A bunch... love the Ucha Katana, which I do not. I'm almost dead. Double drink! This puts water in here. I don't know what that does either. So we're not going to use that right now. I just don't know. Maybe it lets you walk in lava for longer, like the lava you can walk in. I don't know. Where am I going? I'm not doing anything smart anymore. And he also has infinite titanite, large titanite. So that's good. So we can actually benefit from that, I think. Whoa. Getting a little dangerous here. A little titan loose. Okay, we're done with this area because we're not going to fight Smelter with no Estus. That's literally suicide. So we're going to bone out of here. Let's bone out of here. We got 15,000 souls, which is enough to level, but I think we should go visit McDuff. Let's get off our McDuff and go visit McDuff. He can also upgrade weapons, so if I was short on large titanite, I can use him to upgrade it. I know there's an item there, but I believe it's a human effigy. And I'll probably die getting it. So let's go to McDuff's workshop. Whoa, pantless knight. That guy values his torso, but not so much his bottom half. His legs are exposed. Weakness, legs. Here, McDuff working his McDuff off. Never open this treasure. After you light that torch, McDuff moves over there. Twinkling Titanite, Craftsman's Hammer. I'm gonna give him the ember. He's gonna call me an imbecile for not giving it to him.
So, right now, you've got gimmies.
So you can buy Bastard Sword, Ucha Katana, Great Axe, Wing Spear, Scythe. Oh no, Scythe? Longbow, Light Crossbow, Royal Kite Shield, Arrows. His iron arrows become infinite later. I don't know what causes that, but I know it's a thing. So let's use Reinforced Weapon. What are we at? Oh, wow. Embarrassing. So, yeah, let's do that. Titanite Chunk. Yeah, buddy. So what are we looking at now? We are looking at Longsword plus 7, 8, 9. So we need 5 chunks to make that a 9. And then a slab, which we already have, to make it a 10. Wow, we have not upgraded our gear in a while. This is looking bad. Looking bad. Looking bad for me. I think upgrading the catalyst will help with our magic weapon. So let's buy 2 more catalysts. Two more large titanite. Oh, okay, yeah. So we're back on chunks. Alright, so now our weapon's better, our catalyst is better. Let's go back to the Iron Keep. We still want to pay that merchant, the dragon merchant guy, more souls to get the Gold Covetous Serpent Ring plus one. I know what you're thinking, but you don't even have the regular gold Covetous Serpent Ring. You actually get that item in this area, and it's takes a lot of falling to get. And it's we're about to get the plus one version, so I don't know. Logic. Oh, we pulled both because I wasn't paying attention. That guy's gonna definitely stab me. Definitely doing more damage. Feels good. So we're gonna kill all these guys before we fight Smelter. And then... we can either... Oh crap. Sit down. I think their armor looks really cool. It's like that... It's like black full plate almost. I don't know... It's like if these really badass looking, I don't know, knights use katanas? I don't know. It's kind of a blend of Eastern and Western armor. Which I think is just really, really cool. I love that design from. Ow, I tried to dodge that and I failed. Using a lot of those, I don't know why we have tons of Estus. It's not like... Smelter is going to have an extreme large amount of time to drink on. Playing it safe, man. He's right behind me. Oh, I was about to say that's going to hit. Katana has reach on that thrust. I was about to say, I don't think I'm under the awning. It's the last guy we're going to play it safe with. It's not just the damage, sometimes those guys hit you and it like staggers you or hits you just enough that those guys can melee you while the ballista guy's shooting. Sometimes you pull this guy, sometimes you don't. Alright, so that's... There's one more guy we're going to kill before Smelter, but let's see if these 13,000 souls is enough to appease the Wanderer's heart. Buy the rest of the Jester gear. The hat's good if you're farming for certain items. These are good if you want to fall. And that's good if you're PvPing. It's kind of like the ultimate PvP set. Oh, we kind of want this. Let's actually use souls to get that. Can never use enough branches, or never have enough branches, I mean. That was a little bit overkill, but we still have to feed this guy souls. Let's buy his branch of yore. Let's talk to him. Boom. Totally worth it. Great item right there. So basically this single episode, we upgraded our soul intake and our magic find incape. Take with the Jester's Cap and that gold Covetous Serpent Ring plus one. Alright, so we have to go through one captain before we can fight Smelter. There's an NPC for this fight, Lucille, whatever her name is, the swashbuckler chick. We're not going to summon her. First, we've only died once, so I don't really want to use an effigy. Second of all, I don't think she helps. I think she makes it harder because she usually dies pretty quickly, and I like an easier Smelter Demon. This guy's going to allow us to enchant our weapon later in the fight because he makes himself better in the fight. Here we go. For melee characters, for a roly type, the trick to this guy is to roll behind him and always leave a little bit of stamina. So whenever he attacks, try to get to one of his sides and roll behind him. I'm going to actually let my stamina get up. This is him making himself more powerful. Back up, get our stamina. Swing behind him. Sometimes he does a move where he puts his sword in the ground. You want to run from him because he does a Nova. Oh, I thought he was going to swing twice there. That move, break lock. That's the Nova. I think we can get a hit in. Okay, this is him upgrading his fire again. I'm going to actually upgrade my weapon. Or by upgrade, I mean enchant. He does do melee fire damage now, so my health will tick if I'm close enough to him. So that's something we have to be aware of. You can just walk out of that second attack or dodge. I usually dodge just to be safe. He does have a ranged attack with fire now. Ooh, I just took that. Shite. Oh, he's going to not Nova? Oh, crap. I need to heal. Double drink. Dodge. Okay, that was close. As with most bosses, the best time to drink is after they do something stupid, so I think it's actually easier to drink after they miss a bunch of attacks than to just try to get away and drink. Like, I actually kind of want to drink again. This is adaptability not saving me. Well, so that was bad. We were close. Boo. I guess I'll bring us back at attempt number 2. Alright, everybody, we're back. We're going to take down this Smelter Demon. Let's get our weapon enchantment going. Smelter Demon ain't got... Whoa! That was incredibly rude, buddy. I don't even know where you came from. Alright, well, I was just saying, Smelter Demon got nothing on us. But we are going to grab our thing in case Smelter Demon does have something on us. After fighting him before, he just seems so slow in the beginning. I guess each time he does that fire move, he powers up, I guess he gets a little faster. That was a huge whiff. That was a greedy hit. Alright. As I say that, he hits me with some slow attacks. I guess we should drink. I am diving a little bit early, and that's the problem. Alright, he's powering up. I'm gonna drink. Looks like someone likes my giant's message. Looks like somebody gets the reference. Okay. I might actually die if I just get near him. We're gonna drink. We're gonna double drink. We're gonna not dodge that. Wow, we're almost gonna die. I have to say, we're doing really bad even before he powers up. Just slow it down. We can beat this guy. Just making some early mistakes. See the fire hurt me there. Ooh, okay. Oh, we gotta run away from that Nova! Which he didn't do. As far as boss Novas go, that one's not the biggest. It's a good time to put our re-enchant our weapon, though. Punishment in. Get a little of his free fire damage in. That was all adaptability. I don't like my current position. I'm in like Smelter Demon crotch and it is burning up good. That's the attack I keep failing to dodge. It's that slow strike down. That one. Because I was talking about it was still in my head. I actually need the life gem. Ooh, almost didn't dodge that. Taking some free fire damage. Oh, that's gonna hit. Ooh, I got it's because I rolled twice. If I only rolled once, I would have got hit. That is the scariest move, in my opinion. Getting some good rolls in now. Playing a little better. Can use that time to heal. I was going to try to get another hit in, but the life gem was a little slow. He's almost down. Ooh, doesn't mean I could take a hit in the face like that. Oh, I think I staggered Smelter. That's why we carry life gems. Don't want to get hit by that Nova. Well, are gonna punish him. We go for the kill. We go for the kill, right? Yeah, we go for the kill. All right, so that's Smelter Demon. What a pain in the buttocks. I'll take that Smelter Demon soul, though. Thank you. I'll take all this beautiful, beautiful soul money. Open up this chest. Porcelain shield. It does not sound that good. Before we spend those souls, let's go revisit an old buddy real quick. Smelter Demon's an optional boss. He gets you that bonfire, which is cool, but there's another bonfire you can get from the belfry, one of the belfry things. Hey, it's the Pursuer again. Yay. Back with his nice curse attack. So I want to stay on the side of the circle that I'm on right now. Because if we go too far towards the door we entered the Smelter Demon fight, there's one of those captains, and I'd rather not get shot with those ballisticized arrows while fighting this dude for the second time. So it's just like before. I think he has more health, does more damage, but other than that, it's the same fight. Yeah, he doesn't have a health bar, but he's going to give us a ring that we're going to use, so it's definitely worth killing. Still think this battle's cool. It's very, like, mobile. Oh, take that stagger. I don't want to get cursed. I do not want to get cursed. Or power you up, or whatever you... Let's see if we can get two hits in. Nope. Oh, I thought that was really early. We have no stamina. We need to get our stamina up. You failed me, Lock-On! Oop, that felt greedy, yep. Feels greedy, it's usually greedy. Oop, yep. Well, now we're gonna have a more powered up Pursuer. Thanks for the curse, buddy. I appreciate it. We were doing so well, and then everybody died. Oh, you didn't do the third attack? No curse again. No curse again. One curse is enough. He had a little spring in his step there that I don't normally notice. Not the most exciting. I mean, it's kind of neat looking, but not the most exciting fight. Oh, he's going to hit me there. He's doing a lot of damage. Went for the double drink. I guess it ended up working. Just slowly beating him down. Quit that. Ow. Shut up. Ring of Blades plus one. It's better than a Ring of Blades. Those things are usually slightly heavier. I'm just going to kill this guy. This is the guy we didn't want to aggro. Now it looks like he's like impossible to aggro. But I've definitely had him fight me during that fight before. Right, now let's go spend those beautiful souls. Gonna go spend those beautiful souls. Alright, we're actually gonna call this an episode that we'll spend those beautiful souls next time. Did a lot. Did a lot here. Farewell, everyone. Back. See you in Majula.